All right. Okay. So apparently, the problem we had before my hiatus and right now with the entire key algorithm token manipulation stuff was it's a really stupid problem. So in Linux or Unix, usually files end with a new line. So that's why here I had a new line. Apparently, that's not the case for public keys. Now that I removed this empty line here, it worked. All right. Okay, but now we're in, which now it tells us, error, this action is not available. We have the following actions. One, which is send a request, and two, which is create a log file. Now, that's perfect for us because now we can spin up a web server with a reverse shell and just run a PHP reverse shell, maybe. That'd be nice. So let's try that. Let's go in here, this up, and let's do a PHP ref shell PHP. And in here, we just take the simplest, what is it, PHP shell. Oh, that looks nice. This looks like a nice shell. So let's get this raw. Let's copy it. Let's go in here. Let's paste it. Boom, 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 boom. Can I just open a new tab here? New edit action fire. And my IP is the following. This one. And now we try this with actions send it and send it. Okay, now I'm confused. Do we have the description somewhere? So let's try this. Which one was this one was the correct one. So now we go to webhooks UID, which if we can duplicate this tab, this is my UUID. Here we go to webhooks check. Then URL not defined. Fantastic. So now we have to pass these two things into the body, which we paste here. And then we just say the URL is, what's my IP again? This one slash 2069 slash, what did I call the file? Shell. And the method would be get. I think that's how it's supposed to work, right? Okay, so we got something. Now the question is, where the hell is it? Now the question is, how can we abuse this to not only have like a PHP file, but actually create a persistent reverse shell? Now, maybe, I'm not too sure, we can get this, but do we also know where this is saved? Like, can I just go in here and then just shell? I don't think so as well. Now, the question is, what the hell are we supposed to do with this webhook thing? We can hopefully upload some things. Registration logs, webhooks. So are those triggered when we register? So let's try this again. HTTP, let's go register. Register here. Let's log in and sign up. Okay, so we get successfully registered, but it doesn't get the shell again. Now, okay, that's kind of useless. How could we do this? We need to find a way where we can, like, call a URL or something like that. I'm not sure where we should find this stuff. Was it PHP? I'm not even sure it was PHP, but I think it was it was PHP. I mean, do we have any, like, resources? We have a console which goes to routes console. All right, I'm still trying to find out what I can now do with my newly gained access to this API. I can send requests. That's amazing. Hang on, is the request one really the amazing one, or is maybe the create log file one? Hang on. Okay, I'm just thinking, if we could create a log file and call it however we like, we could essentially exploit a command injection. Yeah, let's try that. All right, okay, the method would be create log file. This is the UUID. Let's change the UUID. And the body now obviously needs a log name and a log content. Now, for the log name, we are gonna try a command injection, because why not? We are gonna call it test log, log, followed by a reverse shell, which we are gonna build right now using our favorite tool, RefShell, using our correct IP. Copy this one. Let's just, this wrong one. Let's just run it in here. And then we copy this one. Let's just hope it works. Followed by a space and the hashtag. Now the only question I have is how the hell do I do a hashtag? Because the normal combination doesn't work. All right, hang on. I have to do it on my host machine and then paste it into my VM. Okay, that looks like a hashtag. Perfect. And now for the log content, I don't care. Let's send this. Only letters and numbers to be me. Huh? I mean, we can try this one. We have a couple of shells to try. I can even use dots. All right. Okay. And how am I supposed to read this? Look, now I'm utterly confused because isn't there a way where I can like list my webhooks? Apparently not. I have to find a way to, wait, can I just like put whatever I want? So let's call this one shell. Let's go into any basic bash shell. Let's copy this one and let's go in here. Maybe the content can contain it. Okay, but now what the hell is that supposed to help me with? And let's go with sanity. Does it check if this email already exists? Yes. It checks it somehow. And it three. Okay, did that trigger the webhook and now I'm getting a shell? No, I don't think so. That would be too easy. And we can't have it easy. We are on a hard challenge after all. I mean, I should maybe think of a concept where I'm allowed to like use the solution as a lifeline, but with some form of punishment. Like if I were on the treadmill, I could increase the speed of the treadmill or something like that. Leave your suggestions down in the comments. I mean, that's as much an event for you as it is for me. So don't forget to leave a comment or maybe just in the chat. But for now, we have to find a way to make this work. So we can write files. Now, it doesn't like reflect what it's. So let's just go with, for example, .log. If I try that, then it says only letters and numbers. What happens if I escape this dot? Then it says log name not defined. Okay. And what is the HTML? We can do that in here. And let's say, for example, log HTTP and code as URL. Now we do this and we go in here. No, that's the wrong one. We go to this one and then we send it. Of course, we have the percent that's not allowed. I mean, this would be like a great thing to fuzz or something like that, because now I have to do it manually. So is minus allowed? No. I'm not sure how these webhooks can be exploited or if they even can be exploited to get a shell, but I'm pretty sure that we will find that out in the next episode. See you then. Bye-bye.